Okay, so now today we'll extend this dashboard which we are creating. So one straight graph which came to my mind which would be useful for the owner of the shop is getting a graph of these channels. So for generating a graph, the process is you select the data including the heading. So I selected this channel amount and maybe extend to down, or as of now let's select this because we know okay, there's only four channels. Go to insert and chart. If you go to chart type, you will see different kind of charts available for you. I think the best chart for this case would be this one, and insert. So this is on eBay, this is the amount on channels, different channels. Let us change this to dollar and reduce okay decimal places. Now this is the graph, and to make it beautiful and more user friendly, what we can do, we can change something. So if you click on this blank area, a pop-up comes up to define the font and color. We'll choose background color as black. Then we can go to each and individual element and change the color. So if you select this bar, you get a pop-up to choose what should be the color of this. And if you choose this as white, all become white. Maybe we can go ahead with this. And then you select this and again choose this amount, this bar, channel, legend, and the heading. So now this is your amount versus channel graph. If you change the date, by the way, I just added few more extra data so that we have some data of Feb and some data of March. So now if we change this date, let's say from 10th Feb to 25th, instead of 25th, we write 5th of March, the graph changes. And similarly, the amount also changes. Now, one more thing we can add is how many new customers were added between this date to this date. So, new customer acquired between dates. So let us say we will get this wrapped up in this cell, and we'll get the answer in this cell. Now how to get the new customer? So first of all, let's take the filter and get the name of all the new customers equal to filter. So customer name must be in these columns. So this is the thing which we need to filter. Now what are the conditions? So condition number one is okay, this column date should be greater than equal to this date. Condition number two is okay, this date should be less than equal to this date. If you see, the list has a lot of team members. So basically, whenever we enter some inventory or remove some inventory, the customer name entered is team member. But we want only actual customers. So like James, James Bond, Mona Lisa, and so on. If you see, if it is a team member, then channel C is blank. If it is not a team member actual buyer, then channel C is not blank. And if you recall, during our function session, we had a function which was is blank and not used to reverse the selection. So basically channel C should not be blank, and we can insert this condition over here. So right now this one and two condition, date should be greater than A5 and less than B5. We can add the third condition, which is not is blank channel C. Is blank closed, not closed. Now if you see, you get only names of only customers. So this list is of only customers. There is no team member. Now we don't want the list. We actually want the count, and that to the unique count. So if we apply count unique to this entire array, you get how many new customers were acquired. So this is equal to count unique and close entire thing between this. So between this total new customers, it should not be acquired because there may be few customers who had been in the platform before. So total 6 unique customers did some sort of shopping between this date. Now again, if we beautify this, I don't know how to beautify. Let's copy the same thing, sales, and reduce the font size. New customer between dates, and this one middle, vertical middle font size can be 24, background, I don't know, you can always play with the color. So new customers between date is this. Next we can calculate what was the total return or refund. So let us copy this and paste over here and make this as total return slash refund, and there should be a space over here. Now if you see, we decided that there can be something called return item or refund item, and let us add some column which is actually a return. So let's say this was a refund and this was a return. Okay, so let us have only two things, or maybe one more over here, refund. So total number of return or refund. So we want the count of this if action is return. So equal to count if range is this and criteria is refund. So you have total 2 refunds, but we are looking between dates. So total return refund between dates. If we go between dates, then there are 2 more conditions, that it should be greater than this and less than this. So now count if cannot be used, it has to be count ifs. So count ifs, this become criteria range 1 and criteria 1, comma, criteria range 2, this and criteria 2 is greater than, equal to, and this date. Criteria range 3, this, criteria 3, less than, equal to, and this. So we have only 1 refund between these dates. Just to remind you, make sure in case of count if, sum ifs, or average if, this is how we write the criteria. We write the range, then comma, and then the criteria. And in criteria, there is a special way of writing. In under quotes, you write greater than, equal to, or less than, equal to, whatever is the logic, then and then the cell reference. But in case of filter, you simply write the range and less than equal to cell reference, or greater than equal to cell reference. So this will require some practice, and hopefully very soon you will be able to write those without any errors. Now coming back to this, there is one issue in this. It only counts total refund, it doesn't count return. So what we'll do, we'll copy this entire formula and plus paste. And instead of refund, we will write return. So refund plus return both is still 1, Let's add one between 10th Feb and 5th March. So 10th Feb is here. So let's make this as return. Now if you come back over here, it becomes 2. So total return plus refund between dates are 2. Let us add one more item over here, which is be highest selling product. So let us add that over here. This will be highest selling product. And let's also copy this. When you copy a cell, its a format also gets copied. So now getting this data, highest selling product, is very tricky, and I would request you to pay extra attention and understand what's actually happening. So we'll try to get this in steps. So first step will be get a list of all the products. So we go back over here, and along with the names equal to filter, we want to filter item throughout the quantity, and condition should be this is greater than in fact greater than equal to this date, and this should be less than equal to this date. So you get biscuit invent biscuit and 200. So again, since we want to get sell, we need to get add one more condition, that this column is only sell. So we go back over here and add one more column, and action equal to sell. Now we have these many items which were sold between these dates. Now how to get the highest selling product? What I prefer doing in this kind of cases is creating a helper column and hiding that. I'll tell you in a second what I'm talking about. So let's copy this and paste somewhere over here, equal to paste. Now we and delete this. Now we have a list of items which are sold max, which were sold between these dates. Now we get list of unique items. So unique and select column O. These are uniques, biscuit and oil. And correspondingly, we will get the sum of those items. So sum if criteria is this, criteria range is this, and criteria is this, and sum range is this. And we'll maybe drag this down to some length. Now in this column, we will get a filter of S and T, so that S is not blank. So we get only those items which have some item, some quantity, and sort that list based on column 2. So see what I'll do. Equal to filter this entire thing, S to T. Condition number 1 is not is blank column S. I think this is only condition. So not is blank. So we get this 2. Now I want to sort this based on column 2. So how this works, you can apply sort function to any array, and first argument it takes is the range. So we have the range is column V and W, which has came from the filter. Second argument it takes is the sorting column, which column you want to sort. So we want to sort column 2, and true means ascending and false means descending. So if we write false, So now this is arranged in descending order of column 2, so 110 and then 10. It was an coincidence, is earlier also it was 110 and 10, but actually it has been arranged in descending order. Now this is your answer. So your answer lies in V1. We'll come back over here and equal to V1. So highest selling product is biscuit. And now we will reduce, hide all these columns which we have used. M2W, right click, hide columns. And then maybe we can delete this both. This is not needed. Now this is our dashboard which is complete. So maybe we want to change and see if it's working. 1 March 17 to 5 March. There was no sales between 1 March. Okay, there is 14th March. So no sales between 1 March and 5th March. So maybe 1 March and 20th of March. So total sale is this time highest selling product is oil. So this is our first complicated sales dashboard. I would request you to start from scratch the same dashboard and go step by step and try to create similar thing, and also come up with some new ideas and implement it over here. These were few of the ideas which I had in mind and I implemented that. You can get n number of quantities, n number of data point to show in your dashboard which you think is important. So with this we come to a end of our third dashboard. We'll soon start with our fourth one. See you in the next class.